He got on television and he said, you ain't got to pray no more. He said, Jesus prayed for you. I said, the devil is a liar. Luke 18 declares, men ought always to pray and to faint not. 1 Thessalonians 5 declares, pray without ceasing. He didn't say if you pray, he said, but when you pray. You know what's wrong with us? You want to know why you got mess in your life? Because you don't pray. He said, pray lest you enter into temptation. I can tell people who spend time with God. I can tell in your life. I can tell the way you live. Because when you spend time with him and you have fellowship with him and you commune with him, your desire is to always do those things that please the Father. But some of you in here today, you don't pray, you don't fast. God spoke to me the other day. He said, son, if Jesus had to pray, who was perfect, who did no sin, who never did no evil, if he had to pray, how much more you got to pray? You want to know why I pray? I was talking to somebody and they say, you act like you holy, you praying all the time like you holy. I said, I'm not praying because I'm holy. I'm praying because I got stuff in my life that I need God to break up off of me. I'm praying because I got demons on my back. I'm praying because there's a war going on in my members. When I would do good, evil is always present. I'm praying because I got mess in my life. And if I don't pray, I got demons from my daddy and demons from my grandfather. Generational curses that the devil wants to bring upon my life. But if I pray, I can beat the devil. I got to pray. Shake your neighbor and say, I got to pray.
Hallelujah.
Shake somebody real hard. Come on, shake them real. Come on, don't play with it. Shake them.
Come on, somebody.
They get mad at you.
Are you hearing this? We gotta pray. We gotta pray. We gotta pray. Hallelujah. We gotta pray. My goodness, we gotta pray.
Like you never saw them before. Missouri ain't seen nothing. New York City ain't seen nothing. I don't care what nobody say. It's the wrath of God coming upon the children of disobedience. But if my people, which are called by my name, humble yourself, pray, seek my face, and turn from your wicked ways. I need you to run to three people and tell them it's praying time.
It's praying time. Hallelujah.
You got to pray because the devil is after your children. You got to pray because there are demons after your family. You got to pray because there are spirits that's been assigned to your house. And unless you pray, you can't keep the devil back. You got to pray because there are demons assigned to your ministry. Let me tell you something. You can't find nothing else to pray for. Every morning I wake up, I rebuke the wandering of my mind. I pray that my mind don't leave me. Come on, don't act like your mind don't walk away from you. You can run down the street and forget where you're going. You can pick up the phone and forget who you're about to call. But Isaiah 26 said, I'll keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on me. I've not given you a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. I got to pray. I got to pray so that I don't enter into temptation. I got to pray because there's a war going on in my members. I got to seek the face of God because I told God the only way I'm going to be like you is I got to spend time with you. I got to have fellowship. I got to have communion. Some of you in here, you wonder why you backbiting and bitter. You wonder why. You want to know why? Because you don't pray. He said, pray lest you enter into temptation. See, prayer is intimacy with God. But there's a law in the spirit that if you don't talk to God, you automatically begin to talk to the devil. So the reason you bitter and the reason you backbiter and the reason you full of malice is because you've been talking to the devil. And that's what the devil is. But God's getting ready to raise up a people that are saying, listen here, I'll cut off whoever I got to cut off. I'll let go whoever I got to let go. such an anointing that my spirit is going to be anointed. If you're hungry for his presence, if you want his glory, if you want God to restore your prayer life, jump on your feet and shout glory.